The name of this video is Dynamic Charge. In the beginning of this course, we studied, we investigated the concept of electric charge under static conditions, and we gave an operative definition of electrostatic charge, if you want. So, for example, we defined the conditions under which two objects are characterized by the same charge, that is, the forces on a test object have to be the same, at least the amplitude of these forces has to be the same. We also discussed the concept of addition of charges, so the additive property of charges, which are all part of this bundle, which is called the operative definition of electrostatic charge. Now, in this last part of the course, we are going to encounter dynamic scenarios where charges can move in space and time. So, for example, let us consider a scenario where instead of having in general, we are going to encounter scenarios where up until now, in the static case, we had charge distributions, and they could be discrete or continuous charge distributions, where all these charges were fixed in an inertial reference frame, okay? And also the test charge where we were observing the electrostatic field was fixed in an inertial reference frame. Now, in this new part of the course, we want to study scenarios, cases, where charges are not fixed anymore in an inertial reference frame. Instead, they can move with a certain velocity in these inertial reference frames. So, for example, in a generic inertial reference frame like my lab, let us consider the motion, the dynamics of a single, we start with the simplest case, with a single point-like charge particle in space. So, single point-like charge. We always start from a single point-like charge, as we've done for the static case. Now, let us consider a single charge, let's say with a charge Q2, which moves with a certain velocity along a certain path. So let's sketch the path in orange. So it comes from some direction here, it follows this path, and this path, as always, is represented by an oriented line, gamma. Okay, so here we have a charge Q2, which eventually ends up at a point here. So this will be my charge Q2, which moves at that point. So this point is a point capital P at a time t. This particle would be characterized by a velocity which has to be tangent to line gamma at that point. So this velocity is v of this particle Q2 at point capital P and at a time instant t. This motion happens while this charge is located in the electrostatic field due to another charge, a source charge. The source charge, let us call it Q1. This is a source, and so we located a point capital Q. Observation point capital P as always, and source point capital Q here. Note that while this charge is moving, Q2 is moving, this charge Q1, we hypothesize that is still fixed in an inertial reference frame, IRF, inertial reference frame. Okay, so we still hypothesize this, whereas this one can move. We then measure, in red here, by means of a dynamometer, for example, the force, which we know is due to Coulomb's law, due to Q1 and Q2. So we know from Coulomb's law that it has to go in this direction. Let's call this force F on 2 due to 1 using our usual notation. And this is a point P, T. So a point P in space and point T in time, if you want. All right. So we measure F to 1, we store it. The next thing we do, we assume that there is another single point-like charge with charge Q2 Q2 prime, which moves along a different path, gamma prime, still in presence of Q1, which is fixed. So for example, this one could be a path like this. This path, we call it a gamma prime. And in this case, as I just said, we have a charged particle, a single charge, Q2 prime, which moves along this direction, and eventually it reaches this point P, but at some other time T prime. So eventually in this point along gamma prime, I will have my charged particle Q2 prime, but now the point is the same point P, because that's where the two curves gamma gamma prime encounter each other, so they share this point here, which is P, but the time can be a time T prime, a different time, okay? Doesn't have to be the same, of course. We want actually to be a different time. All right, so now again, we take our dynamometer, I mean the Coulomb's law, we measure the force on Q2 prime due to Q1. So in general, we could find a different force compared to F2 1. So let's sketch it as something like, we know that Coulomb's law still works, so it has to have the same direction. So let's sketch it though a little bit longer, let's say. So this force is F2 1 prime. Okay. Now, the two charges, Q2 and Q2 prime, are equal to each other. If you remember the definition we used in the static case, this definition still applies in the dynamic case. So these two charges are equal if it happens that the norm, so the magnitude, the amplitude of F2 1, so the magnitude with sign, positive sign, is exactly the same as the norm of F2 1 prime. This is exactly the definition which we want to have. So in this case, if and only if, we need to put this double arrow. So if these two forces in amplitude are the same, then the charges are the same, and vice versa. Okay, so this is our operative definition of dynamic charge in the dynamic case when the test charge here, the test charges, move. As it turns out, if you take a bunch of charged particles, instead of only one, you take a couple of them or three of them, and you put them close to each other, so you add them, so what I'm trying to understand here is the concept of additive property of charge, this definition still applies, okay? So it's not true only for a single particle, but if I have a group of 1, 2, 3, 4 particles which I put together, add them together, okay, along gamma prime, and same thing, say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, along gamma, the same definition allows us to tell that this sum of charges, this addition of charges, is the same. So the additive property of charge remains valid also in the dynamic case. So under these conditions, people refer to charge as a relativistically invariant quantity. So a fundamental property of charge is that charge is relativistically invariant. So it doesn't matter if I perform these measurements with a moving charge or with a static charge, I obtain the same charge, okay? So if this charge, instead of moving in space, I keep it fixed, so I remove from the problem here the time dependence, I measure the same charge. So charge is said to be time invariant, relativistically time invariant, to be completely precise. Relativistically. Actually, this relativistic time invariance, which if you want is a principle of physics, so this principle is the principle which eventually will allow us, not in this course, but in 342, in the very beginning of 342, it will allow us to show that the electrostatic field E or more in general, we will discuss about the concept of the electric field versus electrostatic. So the electric field E and a new quantity which we're about to discover, the magnetic field B, are basically one and the same phenomenon. You need to use this relativistic time invariant charge in order to prove this in conjunction with Lorentz force, which is the topic of a video coming up soon. So at the beginning of 342, we will show by means of a simple relativistic argument of special relativity that E and B are actually basically the same phenomenon. And this time invariant of charge is the key element to make this proof, which is quite beautiful. It really shows that basically we're studying the same phenomenon, that's why it's called the electromagnetic phenomenon. Okay, so to summarize this video, dynamic charge, we just started to move away from static cases. So we still kept the source charge fixed, but we move the test charges in this case. We use the same definition, the same operative definition of charges we've done in the static case, and we find that experimentally, this is all experimental evidence, that if I measure the same force, well, also when the charges are moving, the charges are equal. And this also applies if I sum up charges together, if I add charges, so also the additive property is still there. And it doesn't matter if I do this experiment at a certain time or another time, so in statics or dynamics, at different times if you want, the charge is still the same. So the charge is relativistically time invariant, which is important to show that E and B, this magnetic field to be introduced in the next video, are actually the same phenomenon. That's it.